Like all plants, trees capture carbon dioxide directly from the atmosphere, and they use that carbon to grow. But in the course of their lifetime, they also pump a lot of that carbon into the soil, where that carbon feeds a microbial community that traps that carbon within the ecosystem for hundreds or even thousands of years. And that means these ecosystems are really important for trapping carbon away from the atmosphere and limiting climate change.
It's important to restore land for many reasons and at many scales. I think often the narrative goes big. Restoration can be a huge part of tackling climate change. It's an incredibly important solution to this global challenge that we face. I'm Clara Rowe, and I am Restor's CEO. Restor is a new open data platform, and fundamentally, our mission is to enable and to accelerate the global movement to restore Earth's ecosystems.
I'm Tom Crowther. I'm an ecologist studying in ETH Zurich, working on global ecosystem ecology. Restor is almost like a Google Maps, but for restoration. So you don't see hairdressers and shops, but you see restoration projects and nurseries of trees where you can engage with people to help in the restoration movement.
It was founded by the Crowther Lab at ETH Zurich and co-developed together with Google.
Crowther Lab uses Earth Engine, and as they were developing their global maps, they ended up needing some help trying to get those things to scale. My name's Noel Gorlick. I'm a software engineer at Google, and I'm one of the co-founders on Google Earth Engine. We built Earth Engine so that all the labs around the world that are all repeating that same effort, trying to process that data and get it ready to use, don't have to do it anymore. We do it once, and all the people that want to use it then benefit from it being already done. Restoration projects are going on all over the world, and the planting is just step one. In a lot of cases, the trees may grow, they may not grow. The trees may be completely unseen after they've been planted. No one may be near them, so they might not know how they're doing. If you plant a bunch of trees but none of them survive, that doesn't really help the restoration movement. So with continuous monitoring with satellite data, you're able to collect information from all these places and help each individual project separately, but globally at the same time.
We work with data that was produced from a lot of different researchers from all around the world. What we then do is train machine learning models based on this data to detect the environmental drivers and the relationships between the data and our interested variable. For example, tree carbon or soil organic carbon. We can go back in time and see how did the plot actually look like 20 years ago and see maybe when there was, for example, a disturbance such as logging. So we see what the legacy actually is of a plot.
I really like to think about the local benefits that it has and the benefits that it has for local communities who are on the coast and they need to buffer from floods, or the farming communities who are facing droughts and are facing changing seasons and need more coverage of the soil.
We exist in isolation from nature. A few years ago, before the internet existed, all of our knowledge was stored in books and clever people's minds. And then this internet existed. We suddenly had access to all the world's knowledge and we started learning together. A few years later, we had Google Maps and suddenly we could now see where we exist in relation to the rest of the world. But we are still entirely disconnected from nature.
Our hope for Restor is that it changes everyone's conception of how they interact with nature. Just like Google Maps changed the way many of us saw ourselves in space, we want Restor to change the way that we see ourselves in nature. We think about our backyards differently because we suddenly think about the carbon that is in them.
We simply could not continue surviving without all of the plants that trap carbon out of the atmosphere, the microbes that recycle those nutrients, the birds, the animals that fertilize those plants and that protect our ecosystems. So bringing back nature is not only essential to preventing the global threats that we face right now, they're essential for our continued happiness and well-being.
Many people are aware of the fundamental dangers of loss of habitats, of the degradation of nature. I think many people don't know what to do about that. And I think many people don't know how they are contributing to it, or if they do, they don't know what to do about that. Restor's not gonna fix all of that, but Restor can be a piece of helping you see where impact is, and it can be a piece of empowering the people who are doing that work of restoring Earth's ecosystems on the ground, making that more mainstream, making that easier to do, making that more successful, and making everyone connected there.